Hi guys, my name is Sanjay Gupta and this is More Than Just Medicine. Today I just want to talk to you about the different types of atrial fibrillation. You may recall that in my last video I spoke about how atrial fibrillation occurs and the fact that I gave you the analogy of a boat and the oarsman in the boat and the fact that the top 15 weak oarsmen stop working. And that condition is called atrial fibrillation. And when the 15 guys stop working, the heart beats at 85% efficiency, or the boat rows at 55%, is at 85% efficiency. The heart beats irregularly because there's no one telling the oarsman to row in a coordinated fashion. And thirdly, that the heart can race excessively or slow down excessively, because the captain of the ship, the captain of the boat, is not working or doing his job at that time. If you haven't seen that, I do thoroughly recommend that you watch that video before you watch this one. Now I wanted to talk to you about the different types of atrial fibrillation that exist. The first is something called paroxysmal atrial fibrillation. So paroxysmal atrial fibrillation is where the heart beats regularly and then can beat irregularly for a while, and then goes back to beating regularly, okay? So that is that the oarsmen at the top, the 15 weak guys, stop because they're tired, they take a rest, and then of their own accord, they start working again. So that is called paroxysmal atrial fibrillation. It comes and goes, all right? Then there is something called persistent atrial fibrillation. In that setting, what happens is that the heart starts beating irregularly and continues to do so continuously for over a week, okay? And that is called persistent atrial fibrillation. That's different from paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, because in paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, the heart beats irregularly, comes back to beating regularly, beats irregularly off its own accord. But these episodes where it's beating irregularly are generally less than a week. When you are in atrial fibrillation for more than a week continuously, it is termed persistent atrial fibrillation. And then you have something called permanent atrial fibrillation, which is that the heart is constantly beating irregularly long term, and a decision has been made that there is no way of getting, or that there is no plan to try and get the 15 guys working again, and the boat is now just continuously being rowed by the 85 guys at the bottom with no contribution from the 15 guys at the top. It is also important to say that atrial fibrillation is a condition that begets itself. What I mean by that is that if you have paroxysmal atrial fibrillation, then as time progresses, your paroxysms will get more, okay? So basically, when you develop atrial fibrillation, even if it's for a short time, it indicates that the 15 guys at the top are weak and they're getting lazy. And then as time progresses, even if they start working again, i.e. you come back to a regular rhythm, they will again take a rest. And as they start taking more rest, they'll continue to take more and more rests, and eventually they'll stop working altogether. So the natural history of someone who has paroxysmal atrial fibrillation is that they will go into persistent atrial fibrillation, and if they're in persistent atrial fibrillation, eventually they tend to go into permanent atrial fibrillation. And those are the three types. So there's paroxysmal, there's persistent, and there's permanent. All right. In my next video, I'm going to talk about what the consequences of atrial fibrillation are. All right, so I hope you watch that. Thank you so much.